Today we talk about the praise to the King of Kings. Praise to the King of Kings. I love to praise. It's not a teaching for leaders of praise or for people, because guess what? You don't know why the enemy is after you so much. If I ask this question, I know a lot of you would be not fine. Because actually, let me make it short. You replace him. He was the one in charge of worship. He has so many ways of worship that all of the timbrels, the tambourines, all of the instruments were in his body. And you can read it in Ezekiel 28. Even when he walked, he will do music when he's walking, because he has timbrels, he has piano, he has harp, he has everything inside his body. So he can do music like you cannot imagine. But guess what? It was not enough for him. He just think, if I can take the place of that one sitting there, it will be great for me. So that is the way he lost his place. And God, guess what? He put all of the same thing inside you, because he wants someone to replace the one who can sing in the morning before he comes. He wants someone, he wants you to take that place. And he make you higher than that angel. And when he make you higher than that angel is the way Satan start being so angry against men, because he was jealous that they replaced him so quick with human being. Amen? So, worship is the essence of why you are Christian. If you're a Christian and you are not a worshiper, or you don't know how to praise, that means you don't understand why you are Christian. Christian worship not only at church. Your life is a worship. Amen? Your being worship God. Amen? So we need to understand that is why I'm doing this class on, when I say class, you know, me is always teaching. Even if I say I will preach, I end up teaching. But God will help me one day. Amen? So as Christian, worship is our life. Worship is more than words in a song. It's a way of living your life. True worship is done while you are living a life with the fear of God. You cannot sing the song, "You love me so much," and you in the night before, you're in the nightclub doing all kind of crazy stuff. That means there's a conflict between what you are saying and what you are doing. The real worship is through your life. How do you live your life? How do you work with people? How do you establish your family? Is everything you do worship God through your action, through what you say, through what you think? So I think Mama Jordette is there. Vera, you let me know. Please open your mic. If she needs translation in French, I can do the both. God will help me.
No, she says it's okay. Mama says she's okay.
Oh, Mama, you're so sweet. Amen. Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So, for the king to be worshipped, you need to praise him for what he has done and worship him for who he is. Today, we focus most on praise. Very great. Because most of the time, we say we are from the tribe of Judah. Because we say, oh, we are African. We know how to praise God. But guess what? It's not because you're African or you know how to dance. You need to understand the meaning of what you are doing. It's what will get you into real praise. Contemplate the greatness of God for what he did. Let's start it. And it started in the Garden of Eden. It actually started in the Garden of Eden. Look what God did. So, Michelle, if you can look at Genesis 1, can you read from 24 to 26? I put only 26 there, but from 24.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Genesis chapter 1 from 24 to 26, I'm reading the Amplified Version, says, "And God said, let the earth bring forth living creatures according to their kinds, livestock, creeping things, and wild beasts of the earth according to their kinds. And it was so. And God made the wild beasts of the earth according to their kinds, and domestic animals according to their kinds, and everything that creeps upon the earth according to its kind. And God saw that it was good, it was fitting, it was pleasant, and he approved it. God said, "Let us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, make mankind in our image, after our likeness, and let them have complete authority over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, the tame beasts, and over all the earth, and over everything that creeps upon the earth." Amen.
Amen. Amen. Look what God did. He created everything that was beautiful. And he created man the last. That means he did all of the good work of creation, because you know from Genesis 1:1, they say the earth was without form. But what he did, he took the time to create trees. Can you imagine mangoes? I was back home lately, Kasimanga for the Cameroonian, they know what it means, Kasimanga. Amen. All of the different, the prunes, all kind of fish, all kind of bird, all kind of parrot, all of this. He created all of this beautiful. Then he created man and he woke up man like, look, man opened his eyes to what? Beautiful creature of God. Amen. You wake up and you say, wow. You are hungry, you just pull the mango from there. I don't know, but Adam has the best life when I look. You can just pick up. You understand? Everything was available. Everything was beautiful. And except perhaps for the tree. You know the story about the tree. Let's not get there. Amen. But everything around was good. Everything was good in the sight also. He created man in a garden where everything was already created and put everything in his hand. So men wake up to admire what God has created. That is where praise started. You admire what God has done. You admire. When you wake up in the morning, Michelle, you look around. You look Naima, you say, oh, how beautiful. Look how she look more than me. Look how she's walking. When she's talking, it's almost like me. And everything. You are admiring what God can do. Amen. You admire. You look at the tree. You look at everything is to be admired. It's the work of God. Amen. That is praise. Praise is telling him what he has done, perhaps through a song, but you are telling him what he has done, what good, that is good in your sight. Amen. We praise him. We have the sun. Can you imagine we wake up, it's still night. It's just the moon every day. We'd be sad, but he put the sun. The sun has to start 6 a.m. It's coming up and everything. That is praise. Praise him for what he has created. Romans 1:19-20. Can you read it for us, Michelle?
Romans 1:19-20 says, "Since what may be known about God is plain to them, because God has made it plain to them. For since the creation of the world, God's invisible qualities, his eternal power and divine nature, have been clearly seen, being understood from what has been made, so that people are without excuse." Amen.
Amen. This verse is simply saying that even if we have not seen God, we can see what he can create, and is already enough for us to admire his work. Even if you cannot see God, Mama Po, when you go in your garden, I know I need to come and pick up some fruit and everything. Brother Christian sometimes bring me some apple and stuff like that. You understand? You just plant. You go to sleep. God make it grow.
Oh, amen.
Amen. You wake up and you have this. And you wake up and you have this vegetable. And you wake up and you have this. That is already admirable. That is already an opportunity to praise God. You praise God for what he created, what he allowed to continue. He didn't only create things that stopped. He created things that can grow. He created things that can give nourishment. He created so many things. So the word in Romans 1:19-20 says, even if in the beginning the things of God were invisible, for since the creation of the world, God's invisible qualities, his eternal power and divine nature have been clearly seen. You can see it. You can see through the creation. If you look at someone, let me take my friend Sofoni, where she is now. You look at Sofoni because Sofoni, she's particular. It's all I can say, amen. I love Sofoni, amen. But you look and you say, if God can create something so beautiful, you understand? If God can create something so beautiful, so you can't, you start thanking him for what he has created in a human being or in the things around you. You have to thank him for what the opportunity he has given you. When he brings someone to you, how you thank God? You thank God for all of the quality put in the person, because the person coming to you is bringing something also. It's why I always say, whatever, whoever come to your door, if you're a Christian, when I say door, in your life, God has put something inside that person. You need to be patient. You need to wait until the person mature. You need to wait until the person is able to put out his quality to serve for the work that God has given. Amen. So you have to understand, we praise God for everything he has done. Through his creation, we can praise him. Amen. The Lord presented his world creation in front of men, and all the man has to do is admire it and praise him. The essence of praising is in what God has done. So we let's go to the next before I go more in my teaching. Every time you renew your mind, because sometimes you can be sad by a problem before the night and everything. But when you wake up in the morning, you say, no, let me renew my mind. You read a new, fresh, new word that gives you faith. What happened? You need to be able to admire the work of God around you. That is a must, especially in this time where we are confined. We are more at home. We are more at home. We are more around the park and things like that. We are actually reconnecting with nature, because we are not running up and down and just busy. No, we slow down. We slow down to admire what God is doing too. So praise are an expression of gratitude toward God. Expression of gratitude. Why you praise God? Because it's worthy to be praised for his work. When are we praising? Anytime. Michelle, can you read Psalm 73:26?
My flesh and my heart may fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever. Amen.
David, even if he say, my flesh and my heart, I am sick, but I praise God. I am in this condition, but I praise God. You praise God in good times. You praise God in bad time. Don't wait to praise God only in good time. No. Even when we are passing through painful moments, that is where you have the meaning, the true meaning of sacrifice of praise, really. Because you can praise God crying. It happened to me once. I was very, very sad, but I praise him with all of my heart. What happened? It was a transformation. It's that day I received a ball of fire inside me, because I was crying. I have no reason to praise him, but I start praising him with all my heart. And I cannot forget that moment. A ball of fire. I saw the ball of fire hitting me, completely transformed again. Because there's different level of fire. Amen. So we need to praise God. That is a difference with the unbelievers. The unbelievers will praise God only when it's good. As soon as it starts being bad, as it starts cursing God. They will praise only when things are good. But a true believer will always praise the Lord. If you find yourself sinning and the consequences of your sin are after you, you need to repent and to start anew with God. What happened is sometimes because of what you did, you can fall under guilt and not be able to praise again. But I tell you, Jesus has provided grace, and we are in the time of grace. You kneel down, you repent, and you go back to praise. You go back to praise. Amen? We go back to praise. Let's go to the next. Now, the type of praise. The type of praise. First, we need time in order to praise. Take your time to praise. Don't praise only on Sunday when we have worship and everything. No, you need to praise. Put praise in your heart. Let it be a spiritual training of your spirit man to praise always. I will continually praise in my mouth. Praise, 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 praise. It will allow you to avoid so many things. Because when you pray, hey, the enemy will see you. He cannot come close to you when you are someone always praising. In celebration, we need to ascend. When you are praising, you need to learn to ascend. You can start the praising slowly, but after you can feel in your spirit and your being that you are ascending. There is an entrance into internal gates. We enter by the corridors of glory to end in front of the throne of grace. I just gave you like a class that can take 1 week there in that sentence, because there's a way of praising that will bring you in front of the throne of grace, that we introduce actually worship. Worship will bring you to in front of the throne of grace. But everything that has breath, praise God. Look at Psalm 148. Michelle, Psalm 148 in your Bible. Psalm 148. Let's look at everything praising God. It will be amazing that you discover that one. Psalm 148.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights. Praise him, all his angels. Praise him, all his hosts. Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all you stars of light. Praise him, you highest heavens and you waters above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded and they were created. He also established them forever and ever. He made a decree which shall not pass away. Praise the Lord from the earth, you sea monsters and all deeps. You lightning, hail, fog, and frost. You stormy wind fulfilling his orders. Mountains and all hills, fruitful trees and all cedars, beasts and all cattle, creeping things and flying birds, kings of the earth and all peoples, princes and all rulers and judges of the earth, both young men and maidens, old men and children, let them praise and exalt the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted and supreme. His glory and majesty are above earth and heaven. He has lifted up a horn for his people, giving them power, prosperity, dignity, and preeminence. A song of praise for all his godly ones, for the people of Israel who are near to him. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. When you look at that song, you will find that all creature, the Bible says, let every creature, let everything that has breath, all creature praise God. They even say the moon praise God, the sun praise God, the beast in the sea praise God. Everything praise God. Amen. How much more you, human being? He gave you a soul. Most of those things, almost all of them, none has a soul. You have a soul. How much more you? But there's three types of praise, and it's like three levels. The first one is called universal praise. Praises is what Sister Michelle just read. Everything praise God. Everything. That is the first level. Everyone praise the Lord. Example, there was a man, that is a testimony I follow. There was a man who was a wizard. He learned the language of animals. So he can enter into someone's house. He can speak to your cat or speak to your dog. And through that, know the way you live. Are you praying in your house or not praying in your house and things like that? So he knows how to launch his attack. One day, after finishing his operation, he went under a tree, was tired. He sat down and he heard this bird singing. I don't eat. I don't eat. He said, I don't walk. I don't plant anything. But you, Lord, is feeding me every day. And the bird was singing to the Lord early in the morning. He said, that is not possible. Huh? Even bird can talk about this Lord. Who is this Lord? And the bird was just singing. Do you know that it's because he saw that animal praising God that he went to ask, but who is this Lord this bird is singing about? And he found out that even Satan that he's serving is not powerful as God. If the bird can praise him, you understand? And he gave up everything he was doing because he said, no, I want to follow the one that everybody praise. Amen? And he gave a testimony. So we have to understand that everything around you praise God. You see the tree in front of your house, that tree praise God. Everything about you. This is why in Luke 19:40, you remember when Jesus entered Jerusalem and everybody was saying, Hosanna, Hosanna to the Most High. And they came and they said, why you don't want people to praise you like that? He said, if they don't praise me, even the stone, you understand? The stone will praise him because everything around you praise him. And we are the last one to understand why we praise God. We think that praise is just part of the service, that you come on Sunday and you hear people praising. No, you praise him every time. We learn to praise him. We live, we enter into his presence with praise. We need to do more than the universal praise, because the universal praise is everyone has to praise him. But we have a soul. We cannot stop just in universal praise. Let's see what is the next. What other type of praise? Can you read Luke 22:29?
Amen. Mm-hmm. And I confer on you a kingdom, just as my Father confirmed one on me. Amen.
Amen. This type of praise, the second one, are the praise of the redeemed. When they say, let the redeemed say so. Amen. The people who have been redeemed, people covered by the blood, also have a type of praise. And Luke 22:29 is telling us that the kingdom that they confer to Jesus, he said, as I confer on you a kingdom, just as my Father conferred on me, the same kingdom Jesus has received, he gave to you Ruth, he gave to you Vera, he gave to you Christelle, he gave to you Viola. This is why you praise him, because he gave you a kingdom. Yeah. Hallelujah. He said, let the redeemed say so. You know you are redeemed, you will praise him. You know you was bought with a price, you praise him. This is when our praise are sacrificed. The fruit of your lips become praise. Israel getting out of Israel, of Egypt, start singing the praise of the redeemed. They were in Egypt, they were not singing. Mm-hmm. When they come out of Egypt, they cross the Red mm-hmm. Sea, they start singing. Amen. After they have crossed the Red Sea, they start singing. And you can hear there's a song of Miriam, there's a song of Moses, there's a song of so many. Every time you go and you are redeemed, you praise the Lord. Amen. Now the declaration of our mouth should be as the way we live also our life. Praising in the time of adversity like in a good time. Amen. So we need to understand that praise of the redeemed, they are higher than praise of universal praise, because universal praise is everyone praising. But praise of the redeemed are the one who know what God has done for them. You hear Christelle in the beginning, she said that 12 years now is not 1 month and two days. 12 years she has been looking for a job. 12. That is time for maturity for the Jewish do something in 12 years. Amen. I don't want to go there. Amen. But you understand, there is something amazing about being redeemed and thanking God for what he has done. And James 1:2 even say, Michelle, James 1:2.
He says, consider it pure joy, my brothers and sisters, whenever you face trials of many kinds. Amen.
Amen. That is when you praise in good or bad moment. You face trial, you just start laughing because you know it's time for promotion. Amen. Amen. You know the Lord will bring you through. Trust me, the church that we knew before and the church that we go through this Christ, that will be after, will not be the same. Because the church after this Christ is a church that demonstrates that Jesus is not just something in the book. He's alive, yes. And he's the one standing for the church. We have to understand. We praise him for this time of 2020, where we have create new foundation, even for new beginning, where we are standing by the word of God and the demonstration that all Lord lives. Before, we couldn't have the time to sit down and prepare the lesson and do as we are doing. We couldn't have the time. Where will be the space to grow as we have grown? We couldn't. But now, look at it. Everyone has a watch, like the weekend. Every of the minister has to watch every 3 hours. They can grow and see what God has put inside them. People are getting saved. People are getting delivered. People receive the word. There's a renewing of the mind of so many people through different ministry and what they can get. That is praise we need to give to God. He gave us time to know who we are. Amen. Let's go to the song of Miriam. This is one song only. And then after, I will talk about, we go and do some exercise on the tongue, on the song. Can you read, you can find it in Exodus 15, the song of Miriam, after they have passed the Red Sea. Can you read?
Amen. I will sing to the Lord, for he is highly exalted. Both horse and driver, he has hurled into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my defense. He has become my salvation. He is my God, and I will praise him. My father's God, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a warrior. The Lord is his name. Pharaoh's chariots and his army, he has hurled into the sea. The best of Pharaoh's officers are drowned in the Red Sea. Amen.
Amen. And you can go on the Bible. She was just telling what he has just done. Can you imagine Pharaoh letting people go for nothing if it's not God? People, slave. You have to understand what happened and how you can thank him with a song. You put a song so you can sing it over and over for generation to understand what God has done. Amen. Before we go to the next and last type of praises, let's study a little bit in the Bible. There are more than 185 songs. You see, we have learned just about the song of Miriam. You will find so many songs in the Bible, and all of them are praise for what God has done, or praise for what God is like, praise, prophecy at the same time. In those 185, you have 150 in Psalms, some of David, some of Asaph, some of Solomon. Just a question, just to tease you. So I will see if you are following me or you are not sleeping. Amen.
Amen.
What is the longest song in the Bible? Who can tell me?
150. 119.
No. Michelle, she has it. It's Psalm 119. It has 1,732 words. If you tell someone, read Psalm 119. That is punishment. Amen. I'm sorry. If you tell someone, especially if you tell him to read the whole psalm before he go to sleep, that is punishment. That is not blessing in the name of Jesus. Amen. Bind that person in Jesus' name. It's the longest psalm in the world. I have an auntie. I will not forget that auntie. She was mean. She will ask us to memorize a part of that psalm. And I look at her and say, you are not good. And these are the things that we not allow people even to love God, just because you take the Bible to punish people. Mm-hmm. Psalm 119, I have a bad, bad, bad souvenir of Psalm 119, okay? But it's the longest song of the Bible. And you have some shortest song of the Bible. And Michelle, you can look, and Ruth can help you. 2 Chronicles 5:13 and 2 Chronicles 20:21. 2 Chronicles 5:13. Those are the shortest one. 2 Chronicles, can you find that one? And Ruth, yes. Look for the 2 Chronicles 20:21. Go ahead, Michelle.
2 Chronicles 5:13. Mm-hmm. And when the trumpeters and singers were joined in unison, making one sound to be heard in praising and thanking the Lord, and when they lifted up their voice with the trumpets and cymbals and other instruments for song and praise the Lord, saying, for he is good, for his mercy and loving kindness endure forever, then the house of the Lord was filled with the cloud. Amen.
Amen. So they have only one sentence, but that sentence make the whole house be filled with glory. And this verse, it has been used in so many songs. For he is good and his mercy is forever. Hallelujah. One sentence only. The whole house is filled with the glory of God. One praise push you in front of the throne of grace. Amen. So those songs are very powerful. If you can, you study some of them. They are powerful for your own ministration to God and everything. So Ruti, 2 Chronicles 20:21.
Amen. After consulting the people, the king appointed singers to walk ahead of the army, singing to the Lord and praising him for his holy splendor. This is what they sang. Give thanks to the Lord. His faithful love endures forever. Amen.
Amen. Same thing. One sentence only is his praise. So sometimes your song shouldn't be, your praise shouldn't be too long and everything. You can just say one thing, but you are praising God. Amen. What was another quiz? Who sang the first song in the Bible? Worship team, I should put you on the spot. Michelle, who sang the... Now, you don't Google that one. If you Google, I can see
Reverend, I cannot, this one I'll leave for others to answer. Otherwise, they'll think I'm monopolizing.
Even if, say, leave for others. Let me go in the back. Who sang the first song?
Can I answer? No.
Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead.
I think it was Jubal.
That Google is too strong. I don't know this one.
No, I didn't Google it.
I'm thinking Miriam.
No, it's Moses who sang the first song.
Moses.
Exodus 15. And he finished the same song you will see is in Revelation 15. Exodus 15, Revelation 15. So Moses, even if he was a powerful leader and everything, he sings songs. Praises to God. Amen. Now, another thing that make me, it was a revelation this morning. Moses, we can see his song in Exodus 15. You follow? Mm-hmm. In Revelation 15, what is happening? The angels are singing the song of Moses. The angels are singing in Revelation 15. So you can sing a song that is so nice in front of the throne, and the angel pick up your song. I didn't say there was copyright in heaven or there are no copyright in heaven. Amen. But just teasing you. What is the song you can sing in such a way that God appreciates it so much that the angel repeat it in front of the throne of God? What praise can you give to God? I tell you a vision I had once in my group, amen, where we, when we start, before I even went to another church and everything, we were in an apartment. We were like 20 or 30. We start praising and praising and praising. And I'm telling you, we praise. I have an open vision of an angel who was going some, if it's, I saw him like in the movie. He was going somewhere. He stopped. He turned around. He has a chariot. He turned around and went to stand and start looking at us praising. I was amazed by it. And the vision disappeared. I said, oh my God. So the way you praise can give, can bring attention into heaven. Heaven can stop 1 minute because of the way you are praising. Mm-hmm. Just to check who is praising like that. Amen. So we have to understand how it works. We have to understand that your praise are not just songs you sing left and right and everything, but your praise are expression of gratitude. And when it pleases God, God responds. So we have the song of Moses and everything. There are other songs in the Bible that you discover. Actually, you have song of Samson. Even Samson sang a song. You have Israel. Israel songs is in number 21, 17, 28. You have the song of Joshua. Joshua sang songs. You have a song of Deborah. Deborah, she sang with Barak. You have a song of David, the Asaph, Jehoshaphat. All of these people, their songs are in the Bible. Even in the Bible, there's an harlot song. You cannot imagine, eh? A prostitute song. It's Isaiah 23, 15. All of those are what? Gratitude. Gratitude. Why they sing? Gratitude. Amen? And that gratitude allowed them to be recognized because the song was recorded in the Bible. So the second part, I say, was the song of the praise of the redeemed. Now we go to next. What is the last one? And it's one of the most powerful praise you can learn or learn how to praise like that. It's the praise of the praises of the just. What are the praises of the just? These are the praises that open the door of prison. The praises that shake all kind of bones. These praises open heaven. As you praise, the Holy Spirit will fill the place and free the captive. The captive are released. You can read it in Act 26. Michelle, can you start in verse 22 all the way to 30?
Amen. The crowd joined in the attack against Paul and Silas, and the magistrates ordered them to be stripped and beaten with rods. After they had been severely flogged, they were thrown into prison, and the jailer was commanded to guard them carefully. When he received these orders, he put them in the inner cell and fastened their feet in the stocks. About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the other prisoners were listening to them. Suddenly, there was such a violent earthquake that the foundations of the prison were shaken. At once, all the prison doors flew open and everyone's chains came loose. The jailer woke up, and when he saw the prison doors open, he drew his sword and was about to kill himself because he thought the prisoners had escaped. But Paul shouted, "Don't harm yourself. We are all here." The jailer called for lights, rushed in, and fell trembling before Paul and Silas. He then brought them out and asked, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" Amen.
Amen. Amen. That one is the third one is the one we are looking for. that means that universal, we know we have it. Redeemed, we know we pass that level. But these are the kind of praise we are looking in New Beginning Ministry, the praise of the just. Those are the praise that deliver people. You start praising, you will not touch anyone. The person start manifesting, scream, and the demon say, I'm out, I'm out, I'm out. Amen. We are happy he's delivered. These are the kind of praise we are looking for. This is where you praise and heaven shake. Where you praise and there's an earthquake in the foundation of someone. When you praise, amen, and you know the person is set free. Those are the praise that allow people to be free. Those are the praise of the just. You become one with, you become an extension of heaven. You praise until the anointing invade the place and free anybody who's there. That is the kind of praise we are looking for. The praise of the just, the one that set free prisoners. When your only focus is on praising God, no matter the situation, you break yokes with your praise. Here we see Paul and Silas singing and praying, although they were prisoners. You see, they have been flogged. They have been beaten. They throw into prison and they start just praising. And they start just praising. And what happened? They were released. What is very interesting in this story is the other prisoners were just listening. But because they were listening, they benefit also the praises of Paul and Silas, because all of them were free at the end. So perhaps you may not sing that way, but you may listen to someone who's very anointed and get free.
Mm-hmm.
So that brings also the importance of listening to praise. You can praise yourself, but you can listen also to praise, because it sets you in an atmosphere where the presence of God, where freedom is already. So it's very important that you praise, but fill your heart also through listening to praise. Amen. So what is stopping you from praise? No matter the situation, the praises should continue to be in your mouth. Look around you, humble your heart and praise him. Hallelujah. I want us, this end of the November, the Lord say it's a year of release. When I was in the flight to coming back here, is where I have that dream. I just saw a hand releasing, and it's telling me it's the time of release. And I said, wow, all of this year we have been pruning, pruning, pruning. That means the roots. We didn't even know where to go anymore. I said, Lord, what is next? Amen.
Amen.
Left and right, left and right. You just need to run every time to make the things right. Amen. Amen. This time it's a release. I say, okay. Amen. It's Amen. Like, you know, there's some prisoners who are so used with the prison that when you open the door, you say, get out. They look at you like, is it a trick? Is it a trick? Because they're so used with the little space that don't disturb them. But God is good, because we are free in Jesus' name. Amen. So before we go to the end, I want, because I keep hearing in my spirit, and brother, if you find that song for us, I keep hearing, hallelujah. I want us to enter into, I know the Lord wants to release some stuff. The Lord wants to release some, I don't know what you are, will be released in your life, but I want you to sing that song, because it's coming. It's coming. It's release, release. I hear release, release, release. I want everyone, you can sing. I want you to sing all of your heart.
Raise your voice and say, hallelujah. Sing, hallelujah. For the Lord God Almighty reigns. Sing, hallelujah.
sing with all of your heart. Let it be released. Let it be a time of release, a season of release, whatever is painful. Release. For the Lord Almighty, pray.
Will you sing it to him tonight?
Hallelujah. Continue and pressing. When you are there, pressing. Pressing.
No one else will do, no.
No one else will do. Pressing.
Draw me near.
Amen, alleluia. Amen, alleluia. Amen, alleluia. Thank you, Father, for your grace and mercy. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you, Holy Spirit. There's a time of release. We still have like 1 week or 10 days. We are the 8 days before the end. But he said, this is a time of release. Take your time to praise. Take your time to praise. Take the time to praise. Hallelujah. When the heavens are open, don't do any mistake of being distracted by what is going on around the world. Take the time to praise. Hallelujah. Put it on your own time, your comfortable time, but give quality praise. Give quality praise. This is already given. It's hovering around your head. Take the time to praise. This is the season to receive. It's not a season to ask anymore. You have asked, now you need to receive in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Take the time to praise. Hallelujah. Send it up and wait that the angel receive it. Ha ha. Take your time to praise him. Hallelujah. Amen. So I don't know if you have any personal prayer requests. You can inbox me in the chat. Hallelujah. But if not, hallelujah, we go to the offering time. I think it's the last slide. Okay. That the Lord, if I receive. I don't know how to make it more. I will just praise him for who he is and let the anointing touch you, because even if you write to me, it will be difficult for me to pray for you here. So let me pray for everyone. I will pray for the sick first, because we have some of our brother and sister who are suffering from COVID. So we want to pray for them. We want to pray for them, for the one who are sick, Father. Thank you, 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 Holy Spirit. Father, you send your word, that you sent your word and heal them. Father, as many as they are, you know all of them by your name, by your name, by the name, Father. You know all of them. We are praying for brother and sister in the camp. We are praying for brother and sister all over the world who are sick, Father. We use Isaiah 53:5. We send your word and heal them, Father. By your stripe, they are healed, Father. Thank you, Father, for your grace and mercy. Thank you for your blood that speaks better things than the blood of animals. Father, we are praying now. We are breathing in the lungs, Father, all of the one who has a problem with coughing, the problem with breathing, the problem, oh Lord, as they are talking, they cannot talk long because of a breathing problem. Father, we breathe in the lungs, Father, as you have done for Adam. Father, we breathe your grace of healing, your healing grace toward them in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we blow inside the body in the name of Jesus. Let your anointing heal them. Let your anointing strike them. Let your anointing remove any sickness from the body in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, touch them, touch them, touch them. touch them as we release the breath of life inside them. Touch them, touch the life in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. We are praying now for problem of family, all of the things around marriage. Around marriage, Father, we come and we bring our sister, brother, the one who want to get married or the one who are expecting marriage in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, you say it's a time of release. We believe this is a time and season also of marriage. Father, all of the things that the enemy has kept for him in the name of Jesus Christ, as we have praised you, Father, let the praise we have released in the atmosphere, oh Lord, remove any locks from marriage in the name of Jesus Christ. Remove any prison from not getting married in the name of Jesus Christ. We break those in the name of Jesus Christ. We release the damsel, like you are saying, the spirit. We release all of the women that are ready for marriage in the name of Jesus Christ into your hand, Father. Father, we know you have find already suitable companion, suitable friend, suitable husband, oh Lord, that will come and marry them in the name of Jesus Christ. We plead the blood of Jesus on them in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray also for the one who are already married, Father. We say peace. We release peace in the house. We release peace in the house. We release peace in the house, in every house, Father, that we have joy of marriage and peace, understanding, Father. Give wisdom to those men. Give wisdom to the woman as well, Father. We thank you for everything in Jesus' name. Now we pray for job situation, for the one seeking for job, looking for job, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, you are the one who gives the power, oh Lord, to make wealth. Father, you know any job that are suiting your children that will go with what they have earned in the school, in the name of Jesus Christ, whatever diploma they have, Father. Father, we pray that they will have a job that is paying them enough, Father. Enough, Father. Father, we don't want job just to feed ourselves and go and pay the rent. We want job that will allow us to do your work, Father. Thank you, Father, for everything. Now we are calling the job to come in the name of Jesus. Claim that job in, claim that job in, claim that job in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the word in the mouth, oh Lord, correspond to the miracle. Thank you, Father, for everything. In Jesus' name, I pray, amen. We pray now for the children, for the one who has children and any kind of situation the children is facing. Father, we are not those children with your blood. Father, anything that the enemy has planted in the heart of that child, we uproot that now in Jesus' name. We plead the blood on that child. Father, we summon the spirit of that child to be bind with the spirit of Christ. Let them be obedient in the name of Jesus Christ. We submit that spirit. We cast out any rebellion from them in the name of Jesus Christ. We say, Jesus, you are Lord. This is a time of release. Any child in captivity of the enemy, now we break the door of that prison in the name of Jesus. We bring them back home in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I want to pray also for the long time dealing with witchcraft of the family witchcraft who never end and everything. And the spirit of death and sickness or things that they die, that they send around you in order to fight you in the name of Jesus. Father, by the authority you have given me in Jesus Christ now, I take authority over all of the power of witchcraft and the forces fighting your children in the name of Jesus Christ. And I say, not by might, not by power, but by your spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. I say divine alignment in the name of Jesus Christ. Divine alignment in the name of Jesus Christ. I strike any arrows coming against them in the name of Jesus Christ with your fire. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we break the grip of the enemy in their lives. Satan, you back up in the name of Jesus Christ. I say the angel that you have assigned in my ministry, ministry, Father, go and release them in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we break the power of witchcraft as we are speaking. As we are speaking, we break the power of family witchcraft. Whatever has been planted on the ground or planted as a tree that has been fighting your destiny, in the name of Jesus Christ, now the angel of the Lord uproot it in the name of Jesus Christ. We take the cross of Christ and we plant it at the place of that altar, and we say the blood of Jesus Christ answer them back now. We erase all of the ordinances that were written against you in the name of Jesus Christ, and we say Jesus is Lord in your life. Jesus is Lord in your family. Jesus is Lord in your house in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, for release of those prisoners. Thank you, Father, for everything you are doing. Now I want to pray, and it's the last prayer I'm doing. It's for the release of the Holy Spirit. The release, let you be filled the way you will remember this day. Father, you are the King of Kings and you are the Lord of Lords. Holy Spirit, you have given us this season. You say this is a generation of Jacob, the one looking for you, the one seeking your face. As we are here, we want to be available to be filled more, Father. Father, all of the people who connect today, fill the cup, Lord. Fill the cup, Lord. Fill the cup, Lord. Fill the cup, Lord. As they are raising their hand, fill the cup, Lord. As they are lifting their face, oh Lord, embrace the face. Oh Father, fill the cup with your presence. Fill the holy temple, oh Lord. Fill them as they have never been filled. Let them be soaked in your spirit, Father. Let your body, the spirit, the soul be soaked in you, Father. As I'm praising, Father. As I praise your name, Father. Father, I know you answer me. Father, I know that you will answer them. Father, let them hear from you. Let them see you. Let them have, oh Lord, this visitation they have always expected, Father. Father, I pray, oh Lord, that you fill the heart. I pray you fill the mind. I pray you fill the spirit, Father. Father, I pray that the anointing of the Holy Spirit enter the house. Father, I pray that your breath breathe on them, Father. Let them be renewed in you. Be new creature in you. Father, I thank you for the anointing that you have put on New Beginning Ministry. May them be your minister, Father, your disciple, Father. Filled with the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I want you to open your mouth and start speaking in tongues. Just start. Just start speaking in tongues. I want you to speak. Just start. Just start speaking in tongues. Just start. Ro 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 ra 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 ra. Pa 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 pa. Ro ko sheke ra 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 sa. Start 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 start. Ro ke ra 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 skere beros. Ro 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 ro. Let him fill you, let him fill you, let him fill you. Start speaking tongues, start, start, start. Ro 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 ro. Pa 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 pa. Re ka re mu mu he he. Just start, 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 start. As you start praising in your own word. He 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 he. He. You cannot be the same. Ra ke ra ye, pa pa ra ye. I want you to renew. I want you to be renewed. Express your gratitude with praise. Express it out. Express it out. Express it out. Rap 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 ras ke le lo place. Let it come out of you. It's like honey. Let it come out of you. come out of you. Let the praise come out of you. You want to renew your situation. You want to change your situation. He gave you that opportunity. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Let it come out of you. Nobody should be doing that at your place. Because if I do it at your place, I will be blessed. Hallelujah. I want you to experience the same blessing I'm receiving. I want you to receive that blessing, even double. Double of what I've received. Hey, praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Let it come out of you. Raye rao shirase. Ha. I give you 5 more minutes. I want you to praise him. Don't be sitting and waiting for the service to finish. What is it for? You have no benefit to that. Praise the mighty King. Praise him. Praise him. Open your mouth and just praise him. Just praise him. Just obey. Let him do what he can do. Five more minutes. His some garment have been changed. Some garment have been changed. Some are receiving the crown. Some are receiving the crown. This is your time of grace. This is your time of glory. Praise the mighty King of Kings. Praise him, oh, praise him. Praise his name. Just praise him. Praise him, praise him. Praise him, oh, praise him. Praise him, praise him, oh, praise. Praise him, oh, praise him. Praise him. Continue. Praise him, oh, Holy Spirit, thank you. Hey, 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 hey. Praise, praise, praise. Hey, hey, praise him, praise him, praise him. Hey, yeah. Rake, hey, ka, hey, ke, papa. Kera kera, roboros kerelase, pa 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 pa. Your eyes are opening. If you can see what I can see, Lord help. Ra pa 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 pa. Praise him and press and press. Rabarat kerero kerera televelas lelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelelel Kerake, Rake, Robo, Kore, Rake, Rabolosse, Papa, Kerevelasse, Lele, Papa, Skelevelop, Lasse, Lotelelap, Laskelevelassa, Papa, Cheko, Pahase, Hey, Hey. He's asking you if you want to become an instrument. Open your mouth. Re-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a-e-a more. 2 minutes more. Praise. Ha ha.
This is a time of.
He's changing your garment. This is not only spiritually. This is physically. 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 Raboropo roparase. Papa ke reveloplase. Reke rabarasa. You will live to testify. Papa ke reveloplate rabarasa. That your praise has led you to a larger place. That your praise has put your name in the history book. That your praise has transformed your life. That the praise that the Lord has put inside you. Reba raboropo rosa. Has opened the way for you. One more minute, praise him, praise him, praise him, praise him. One more minute. Reke rabalosa, rabaraske levelopla, skelebelota, reke rabalopla, celebala, bala, bala, colo, tere, ratele, latele, velasa. Papa, ke rebelopla, celeberasa. Papa, 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 the angel is saying. Make a way, make a way, make a way for the Son of God to manifest. Make a way, make a way, make a way, make a way. Rabaras kerera tereverosa. Hey. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Rabaras. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Amen.